Do you know what one of the biggest problems in AI filmmaking is? The voice.
Yeah, the voice always gives it away. It's too clean, too proper. Nobody actually talks like that.
Real life isn't clean. Sometimes you're in a busy place with people talking all around you, and your voice shouldn't sound like you're trapped in a studio.
And sometimes you sit alone in your car because it's the only quiet place you have. That mood, that honesty in your voice, AI almost never gets that right.
With the right AI magic, a voice can sound completely believable.
And that's what surprised me. Fish Audio is the only tool I found that can faithfully clone my voice. And here's the weirdest part. The voice you're hearing right now is actually generated with Fish Audio. Okay, now it's actually me. I've been using Fish Audio quietly in a bunch of my videos, including one that hit over 70,000 views in its first month. And I haven't got a single code out yet, which kind of proves the point. In this video, we'll explore the best of Fish Audio. I'll show you how to clone a voice that actually sounds like you and use their massive voice library to make characters that feel alive and build dialogue scenes that actually sound like real conversation using their updated Story Studio. Let's start with the one that everyone asked me about. Okay, let's start with voice cloning. Fish Audio is the only tool I've found that actually catches the little things, the texture of my voice, my natural pacing, and yes, also the accent that I cannot shake off. Also, it doesn't try to make you sound like a voice actor. It tries to make you sound like you. But don't just take my word for it. Let's listen to a quick comparison with the most popular voice tool out there, ElevenLabs. Here's my instant voice clone in ElevenLabs V3 version.
So yeah, this is me talking to myself again. I swear this sounded more normal in my head. Anyway, if you're hearing this, it means I decided not to overthink it.
Here's my instant voice clone in ElevenLabs V2.
So yeah, this is me talking to myself again. I swear this sounded more normal in my head. Anyway, if you're hearing this, it means I decided not to overthink it.
Here's Fish Audio S1.
So yeah, this is me talking to myself again. I swear this sounded more normal in my head. Anyway, if you're hearing this, it means I decided not to overthink it.
For me, the difference is pretty clear. Fish Audio preserves the little nuances and imperfections in my voice much better than the other ones. You might not be as familiar with my voice as I am, but to me, it actually sounds like I recorded it myself. So how do we make our own voice clone? It's actually pretty simple. First, we go to voice cloning. You can upload a clean audio sample or record directly inside Fish Audio. Quick tip, here's something most people don't realize at first. They upload one flat sample and expect that AI to handle every mood. But voices change, even with the same person. So if you have a presentation voice, a joking voice, or a sexy late night voice, upload them as separate clones would be better. That way you get way more control over how your voice sounds in different situations. And you can upload as short as 10 seconds to clone your voice with good fidelity. But it recommends aiming for more than 30 seconds for a good input sample. So let's upload a sample. This one, I think it's about 50 seconds, but all the way you can upload to 210 seconds. Next step, we'll add a name, and optionally we can give a description and add text. Set the voice to private. You probably don't want other people to use your voice. You can also set it to unlisted if you want to share with a specific person, like an assistant, so you don't have to record everything yourself. Once that's done, hit create, and Fish Audio will clone your voice. Once your voice is ready, go to text-to-speech, and then we'll click the voice selector. You'll find your uploaded voice under My Voices. You can also choose from Fish Audio's voice library if you want to generate with other characters. Now we just paste in our script. On the right, make sure you're using the latest model S1. If you are on the premium plan, you'll see also the advanced settings. I usually leave the generation settings at default and adjust speed or volume to tweak the results if needed. If you want more motion control, now we can also add tag, and you can find all the tag options under here to use. We just simply have to wrap emotion tags in parentheses before your text to get more precise control of the emotion. And then we'll just click generate.
Hey, can I tell you a secret? I'm just a digital copy stuck in the cloud. Your like and subscribe is literally what keeps me alive.
Having a quiet studio or perfect recording environment is actually a luxury sometimes. And Fish Audio lets your voice speak for you, even when you can't. By the way, if you want to explore more tools like this, join my free community with the link below. That's voice cloning. It's powerful on its own. But what if you need other voices to bring a story to life? That's where Fish Audio's voice library really shines. Fish Audio offers over 200,000 natural sounding voices in more than 30 languages. And instead of being limited to just a few custom voice slots like in ElevenLabs, you can explore a huge catalog of community submitted voices. I really like how Fish Audio lays out their voice library. It makes it easy to find the kind of voice you're looking for, especially character-based voices like these.
You think sanity is strength?
Oh, barnacles, this is the most amazing day ever.
My precious one, in the depths of your uncertainty, remember that I see the greatness within you.
Welcome to Hogwarts, Harry Potter.
You can also quickly find things like anime-style voices, which are usually harder to track down on other platforms.
Did you ever hear the tragedy of Death Plague? Is the wise?
Hello, everyone! Let's create wonderful music!
There are also a lot of extremely realistic voices, the kind that sounds like real people talking in their everyday life, and not voice actors in studio.
I'd honestly rather spend my Saturday morning at a yoga class or trying a new breakfast spot than recovering from a night out.
Okay, you guys literally need to see this new foundation brush I found. It's so incredibly soft and blends everything like butter.
And this one sounds like she's being recorded over the phone.
Just wanted to check on you real quick because I've been thinking about you all day. Sorry I missed your call earlier. Was super busy with work stuff.
You can also find older, vintage radio style voices like these.
Have you ever noticed how we're always trying to arrive somewhere else?
Your imagination is the very gateway to creation.
And you may also recognize some familiar voices like these.
So the key to effective noise reduction is...
Folks, nobody knows noise better than me, believe me. These other companies, they're terrible, just terrible with noise.
And yes, there are even some more spicy character voices that are pretty hard to identify elsewhere.
Just finished customizing my streaming setup, and it's literally so aesthetic.
Darling, I'll give you everything your heart desires.
Look at me when I'm talking to you. Those beautiful eyes belong to me now.
What's nice is that if you find a voice you like, you can bookmark it or add it to your collection and use it immediately in your generations. There's no limit on how many voices you can save or rotate through. You're not constantly kicking one out just to try another one like the other platform. One important note though, some community voices are clearly inspired by celebrities or well-known figures. They're fun to explore and great for testing. But if you're working on professional or commercial projects, I would recommend sticking to the original character voices or your own clone voices, just to stay on the safe side. This tech makes it scarily easy to replicate voices, but with great power comes great responsibility. So please don't use this to impersonate people or do anything sketchy.
I am watching you.
So now you've got your voice, but here's the real problem. What happens when you need them to actually talk to each other? That's where Fish Audio's newly updated Story Studio comes into play. Before, making a dialogue scene with AI was a painful process. You had to generate each line for each character separately, export them one by one, and drop everything into an editor, separate the lines, fix timing and pauses. If one line fails off, you'd have to regenerate it, re-export it, and redo the whole scene. Story Studio simplifies all of that. You get full control over pacing, pauses, and timing, all in one place. To create the dialogue, first let's click Story Studio. And under Advanced Studio Story, we'll choose Start from Scratch. Give your project a name and pick any default voice for now. You can change voices line by line later, so don't worry. And hit Create. That drops us straight into the Story Studio's editor. But for this demo, I already prepared and loaded a project where the script and characters are lined up, but you can just as easily paste in your entire script and just assign the voices as you go. On the left, you'll see the chapter panel. This is great if you're building something longer, like an audiobook or multi-scene story, because it keeps everything organized. In the middle, each line of dialogue lives in its own block. You can add new lines with the plus button and pick who's speaking and choose a voice from the cons or the library. If you want to change the flow, you can simply drag and drop dialogue blocks to reorder them. And under the timeline, if you want to add pauses and align timing, we can just drag the space between blocks on the timeline, and everything after it ships automatically. It's really intuitive. For each line, you can preview it, play from the beginning to the end, download just that specific block, or regenerate it. There's also a generation history in here, so if you prefer an earlier take, you can restore it instead of starting over. Once everything feels right, just hit export for the project. You can choose which chapters to download and whether you want subtitles files included. If you export everything, you'll get neatly organized folder with all your audio and the subtitle files ready to go like this. I didn't touch a single audio editor. Everything you just saw was done entirely inside Story Studio. You can then easily create scenes like this.
Did you eat my pasta?
Which pasta?
The pasta. Blue container. With my name on it.
Oops. I thought that said free.
It said Fran. I used a label maker.
Okay, in my defense, I was really hungry, and it was really good.
That makes it worse.
I'll buy you new pasta.
It was homemade. 3 hours. My grandma made it.
Well, let's check the trash. Maybe some of it's still salvageable.
You threw my pasta away? My pasta? My pasta? My pasta?
Yeah. I'ma come back later.
I ran it through DSign's lip sync tool, which supports multi-character lip sync. You can assign exactly who speaks each line. If you want a full walkthrough, I covered the details in another tutorial video. For the editing, I extended the timing of the final line and added an extra echoed line as the birds fly away. I spent a bit more time on the ending because I had a creative spark while working on it. Everything before that is directly from the original audio timing from Fish Audio.
That's Story Studio, but I haven't told you the best part yet. I know you're probably wondering about pricing, and this is another area where Fish Audio is pretty compelling. Fish Audio has a generous free tier, so you can try their latest voice model, test the voice library, and even clone your own voice without paying upfront. It's more than enough to get a real feel for the quality before committing. And I'm showing the current promotion and pricing on screen. And the best part is with my link and code below, you get 50% off just for you. And so it's really a no-brainer to at least try it out with a free account and see if it fits your workflow. So let's quickly recap what Fish Audio gives you. Voice cloning that actually sounds like you, not a corporate narrator. A huge voice library for characters
and experimentation. And Story Studio where you can cast, write, time and export full multi-character scenes without touching an audio editor.
If you're making AI films, faceless content, audiobooks, or podcasts, try Fish Audio using the link below and grab the 50% off while it's available. If you want to go deeper into this kind of stuff, AI tools, prompts, workflows, and behind-the-scenes testing, I share all of that inside my free school community. That's where I post prompts and experiments I don't always put on YouTube. Link in the description. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.